Hi, this is Dr. Xu, teaching design of experiments for engineering research. In this video, I will show you an example on how I would perform an experiment with a single factor and use an ANOVA table for data analysis. In this example, the strength of one material is potentially influenced by adding one chemical in different concentrations. So the factor we are investigating is chemical concentration. I would like to perform experiments in the concentration range of between 15% and 35%. In practice, you would have to determine a reasonable range based on past research and other constraints. For example, I have chosen the lower limit to be 15% because past research has already shown 15% does not have any significant impact. I've chosen the upper limit to be 35% because adding more than 35% will make the product too expensive and not economically viable. So you will need to determine the range and make sure you have a good reason for it. Next, I have decided to test at 5% intervals. So at 15%, 20%, 25%, 30%, and 35%. This is called the levels. So we have 5 levels. Normally, the intervals between each levels are equally spaced. Also, I would have done some research in supporting the 5% interval and make sure it is not too small that it is so apparent no significant impact difference will occur between intervals. Also, it is not too large that we miss the significant changes within the interval. The intervals also need to be practically easier for operation. For example, we won't pick something like 21.72% unless there is a good reason, because this percent is not practically easy for the manufacturer of the material. Lastly, we decided to test 5 samples at each level of chemical content. Normally, we would repeat 5 or more runs for each levels in this one factor experiment. So this is a single factor experiment with 5 levels and 5 replicates in each level. We will number each of the runs, so when prepare the samples, we can label them. Here I have used numbers from 1 to 25. They are not the test sequence because we will determine the test sequence later in a completely randomized order. You can use other numbers as long as it is easy for you to recognize the sample. For example, alternatively, you can use 15-1, 15-2, 15-3. So this 15 indicates the chemical percentage. This 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 means the 5 observations at level 15%. So you can use 20-1, 20-2, 20-3, all the way to 20-5. And the same numbering system for other levels. The hypothesis we are going to test is, the null hypothesis is the means for different levels are all equal. So the chemical concentration does not have impact on the material strength. The alternative hypothesis is that at least one pair of means in the 5 levels are different from each other. This means the change of chemical concentration does have a significant impact on the response. One thing we need to note that the ANOVA analysis will not tell which level has impact. Maybe all of them are different from each other. Maybe only one level causes different material strength and the rest are the same. Next, we prepare the samples with different concentration. Again, the number on the samples is not the test sequence. It is called the run number and only for labeling purposes. We will need to perform the experiment in a completely randomized sequence. This is called a completely randomized design. Here, I will test the most left one first on each row and continue to the next row. So the test sequence is like this, from here to here, from here to here, from here to here, from here to here, and from here all the way to the last one. To avoid other confounding factors, all the tests will be tested using the same equipment, conducted by the same person, and try to finish it within the same day. The reason we need to do this in a completely randomized design is to prevent the effect of unknown nuisance variables from contaminating the results. For example, if run in the original non-randomized order, the warm-up effect of the strength testing machine will potentially contaminate the strength data and destroy the validity of the experiment. For more information on the completely randomized design, you can revisit my other video on that topic. Next, we will put this table in our experiment notebook. So this is the test sequence. The first sample we will do is the number 8 labeled sample with the concentration of 20%. At the end of the test, we will record the strength in this column. Any observations in addition to the strength, we will put it as notes, so later we know what happened during the test of that sample. These are the results for the 25 samples. You can present the result in a table in the paper like this. This is the chemical percentage, and we have 5 observations at each level of these concentrations. And the average strength for each level are presented in this column. After performing the ANOVA analysis, we got this ANOVA table. I will show you how to get this table using Excel. So in Excel, you have the data here. The rows are each level, and the columns are different observations at each level. If you click Data, Data Analysis, and scroll all the way up, you have this ANOVA single factor. Click it. OK. Select the input range. Here, you only need to select the results of the data. Don't select the levels and don't select the number of observations. Grouped by rows, because each row is a level and the data are grouped by each rows. And the significance level is 0.05. And select new worksheet, so the ANOVA table will be created in a new worksheet. Click OK. Now the single factor ANOVA table is shown here. So you have the source of variation between groups, within groups, and the total variation. The sum of squares here, and the degree of freedom. So we have 5 groups, so the degree of freedom between groups is 4. The total number of observations is 25. So the within groups degree of freedom is 25 minus the number of groups, 5. So it's 20. The mean squares are calculated here. The calculated value here, this is this number divided by this. And also, the p-value is here. It is a very small value, far less than 0.05. So now, with this ANOVA table, we have a very small p-value, and we can make a conclusion. We will reject the null hypothesis, and there is strong evidence showing that at least one pair of the means are different. In other words, the change of the chemical concentration has significant impact to the strength of the material. So in general, in the ANOVA analysis, if we have a p-value that is smaller than the significance level, we reject the null hypothesis. The data provide convincing evidence that at least one pair of the population means are different from each other, but we cannot tell which one is different than the others. If the p-value is larger than the significance level, we fail to reject the null hypothesis, and the data do not provide convincing evidence that one pair of population means are different from each other. The observed differences in sample means are attributable to sampling variabilities, or chances, or random errors that we haven't looked at. In this example, I have shown you how I would done an experiment with a single factor. So I have investigated adding different levels of chemical to a material and see how the change in chemical concentration impacted the material strength. We have 5 levels, and each level we have 5 repeated runs. In the next video, I will show you how to present this data in a plot by using the R program. And also, how do we perform the ANOVA analysis using the R program? This is Dr. Xu. Thank you very much for watching. If you have any questions, please leave a comment. If you think this video is helpful, please subscribe, like, and share. I will see you in the next video.